Well, guess who's back? Boy, that was the longest 3 weeks. It was so strange not being in communication or doing videos. But in France, in the two areas I was in Paris, the internet was kind of crap where I was. But when I left Paris and went on, the internet speed at the first place, it was, we were in a chateau, and the speed was 1 megabit. I mean, I'm used to working at home with 400, and this was 1. It couldn't do anything. And then when we went to the Loire Valley, same situation down there. I have no idea why these places don't invest in some decent internet. So I basically was just kind of in the Bermuda Triangle. It was a great trip, though. I spent my birthday driving across France. It was all behind the wheel with, I think, 1 truck stop. But it was great. We had a really great group of 8 of us doing it. Each team had a car, so we weren't all piled into like a van singing 99 bottles of beer on the wall or anything like that. But it was really an interesting time. You know, for me, when we got to the Champagne region, it's very bizarre because I've never drank at all. And we were in all these incredible Tattingers and Moët, and then all these boutique vineyards that seeing the process was fantastic. I really enjoyed that part of it. And learning about the process, I just didn't partake in any of the tastings. I was like the only person there that wasn't drinking anything. But our group was great. We ended up in 2019 getting this trip, buying it, because my wife and I were part of an organization called Canine Companions for Independence, which raises and places service dogs with people in need. And it's a great organization. And every year they would have their big annual fundraiser. And a few years before this, we all bought a trip to Tuscany. And this time it was to the wine region. And it was great. It's a great cause. And by the time you split it up amongst 8 people, it was an incredibly economical trip. I love doing that fundraiser, and this was a real great result of it. Everything for us went really smoothly, except on the way home, flew from Paris to Dallas to connect, and of course get off the plane and it says your connection's been canceled. So then you're suddenly like, you're kind of wired and you're standing at a counter trying to get a flight out that night because I needed to get home. The dogs needed to be seen and visited. They did great. Anna Laura, who stayed at the house with her fiance, did a fabulous job of taking care of the house and the boys, and she works for a veterinarian, and so she's knowledgeable. So she really took care of business here, so we didn't come back to anything insane. It was all just a transition back in. But it was weird for me. It was 3 weeks of not playing my instrument, and I find that just really shocking. That's rarely happened. And then, of course, coming back on the first day of the NAMM show and getting here that night, and I had been asked if I could be one of the people to induct Carol Kay in the Tech Awards, and there was no way for me to get down there. So I felt really bad about that, because if there's anybody more deserving, I can't imagine who it would be. Carol's place in the music industry is so deep and so profound. But I've been watching Facebook and stuff and seeing all the pictures of everybody from Rick Beato to Sheldon Dingwall, all the cats that are there. So just one of these weekends, and then I'm buried in preparation for Lyle Lovett's tour and getting my house in order for that. And then came back to a bunch of songs people want me to do, and I had about 30 book orders to fill today. So it's all been pretty crazy. You know, it's like you get off and you hit the ground running. But I thought I'd get back into some music here. And I was looking at some credits, and then I remembered having done an album not too many years ago with Kristen Chenoweth, who's an absolutely incredible actress, singer. She's done television, Broadway, movies. And rather than me kind of putting this together, I'm going to do a really quick little read through of her, and then I'm going to play you some of the songs we did because it's really good. Kristen Dawn Chenoweth is an American actress and singer with credits in musical theater, film, and television. In 1999, she won a Tony Award for Best Featured Actress in a Musical for her performance as Sally Brown in You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown on Broadway. In 2003, Chenoweth received a second Tony Award nomination for originating the role of Glinda in the musical Wicked. Her television roles included Annabeth Schott in NBC's West Wing and Olive Snook on ABC's comedy drama Pushing Daisies, for which she won a Primetime Emmy Award for Outstanding Supporting Actress in a Comedy Series. In 2009, she also starred in the ABC TV series GBC. In 2012, played Lavinia in Trial and Error, and in 2018 was the antagonist Mildred Layton in the Apple TV musical comedy Schmigadoon. Chenoweth sang gospel music as a child in Oklahoma and studied opera before deciding to pursue a career in musical theater. In 1997, she made her Broadway debut in Steel Pier, winning a Theater World Award before appearing in You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown, and Wicked. Her other Broadway roles were in The Apple Tree, Promises, Promises on the 20th Century, for which she received another Tony nomination. She also appeared in five City Center Encores off-Broadway and regional theater productions. She had her own sitcom, Kristen, in 2001 and had guest starred on many shows, including Sesame Street and Glee, for which she was nominated for Emmy Awards in 2010 and 2011. In films, she has played mostly character roles such as Bewitched in 25, The Pink Panther, and RV. She played roles in made-for-TV movies such as Descendants, done voice work on animated films such as Rio 2 and The Peanuts movie, and along with the animated TV series Sit Down, Shut Up, and BoJack Horseman. Hosted several award shows and released several albums, including A Lovely Way to Spend Christmas in 2008, Some Lessons Learned in 2011, Coming Home in 2014, The Art of Elegance in 2016, For the Girls in 2019, which is the one I worked on. Chenoweth also wrote a 2009 memoir, A Little Bit Wicked. So it goes on, and she's got a very extensive thing that talks about her whole history in this business, but it's the kind of thing, if you want to check it out, you can go ahead and grab that. But as of right now, this album we did in 2019 called For the Girls, it was produced by Steve Tyrell and co-produced and engineered by John Allen and mastered by Paul Blackmore. Let's see, what song will we start with here? It was really funny. When we premiered the Bernie Williams album, Bernie, the center fielder for the New York Yankees at the time, we did the Ferguson show, and Kristen was on the same show that we were on, met her backstage for the first time when we did that. But I'm going to start with a song that's a Goffin and King, Jerry Goffin, Carol King song, Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow? And it's myself, Russ Kunkel on drums, Bob Mann on guitar, the great Mike Finnegan on organ. This is probably one of the last projects I did with Mike before he passed away. Quinn Johnson on piano, Nito Whitaker is the background vocalist, and it was arranged by Steve Tyrell. So let's make sure everything here is up and running. I haven't done this in 3 weeks. here we go.
Completely, you.
What's going on here? Oh, so it begins. Check things out. Okay.
Tomorrow.
My speaker shut off. I'm going to go back just a little bit here. So it begins. He's back. Techno Peanut here. Here we go.
Gorgeous. A moment's pleasure, and I believe the magic of your size. Will you still love me tomorrow?
Songs. I've cut that with a number of people over the years, including Carol. And it's just a great, great song. What do we got here? It doesn't matter anymore. This was written by Paul Anka. And it's myself, Russ Kunkel, Grant Geisman on guitar, and Bob Mann on guitar and arrangement. So here we go. It doesn't matter anymore.
Use in me a crying, 'cause I've done everything, and now I'm sick of trying. I've thrown away my nights, wasted all my days over you. be no use in me crying, 'cause I've done everything. Now I'm sick of trying. I've thrown away my nights, wasted all my days over you. Now you go your way, baby, and I'll go mine. Now I'm forever till the end of time. I'll find somebody new, and baby, we'll say
just really just a lovely voice, and really, and she's so adorable. She's just the cutest gal, and she's like a tiny little peanut of a, if she's much over like 5'1" or something, I'd be surprised. At least that's the way she appeared when we met. It's so nice to be sitting here with you guys again. I really missed this so much. I was so thrilled with the that you put together the clubhouses in Zoom. I saw the windows up on Facebook with everybody there. It's just so cool. Now this Wednesday, the 8th, is gonna be our next clubhouse meeting. And so I just wanted to give you an extra heads up on that. So that'll be this Wednesday, and then the one-on-one FaceTime and Skypes are gonna be Saturday, the 11th, I believe it is. I leave with Lyle on the 14th, and today Waddy left, I think, to head to Portland with Stevie Nicks to start their tour. I'll be out with Russ, and there's all kinds of stuff going on, and it's been fun seeing Postel out working, posting things from things. So, because we're almost finished with the new album. It's going to be in Nico Bolas's hands shortly to start mixing it, and the movie's almost completed, so at the end of the year, hopefully November, we're going to start working with the immediate family and get our new product out there and get this movie out there as soon as possible. And I can hit the road with my brothers, which I'm really excited about. The hard part, the weird part of this whole thing was, in order to come back to America, in order to leave, we had to fill an incredible amount of documentation. It took hours to fill this stuff out. That's all COVID related. And then once in France, had to be tested before getting on the plane to return home, you know, and you're sitting there kind of going, God, please don't come back positive. And I have to call Lyle and say, can't make the tour, I'm in quarantine. But I'll tell you, as soon as we got on the plane to fly over to Paris, the flight crew didn't have masks. Almost 90% of the people on the plane didn't have masks on. At least 90% of the people I saw on the entire trip, no matter where we were maskless. Yet, you have to be tested. You can't do anything unless you're properly tested. And to me, there's a dichotomy in this that's so incredible that they're basically acting like nothing's happened and we're all good and everything. But on the other hand, you better get tested, and if you come back positive, you can't travel, you can't do... I mean, it's just weird. We are in such a strange time with this, but we all wore our masks all the time over there. Just did not want to take a chance, and I'm still hearing from friends that are doing all they can, but still coming up positive. And so it's just surreal. But okay, one more song here of Kristen Chenoweth, and this is You Don't Own Me. And this is featuring Ariana Grande with her on this one. And this is myself and John J.R. Robinson on drums, Bob Mann on guitar and arrangement, Miklos Malik on guitar programming, Andy Ezrin on piano. The background vocals are Lauren Tyrell, Tierney Sutton, and Nita Whitaker. And again, featuring Ariana Grande with her. And it was written by David White and John Madera. And so here we go. This will be the last tune for Kristen. Such a great classic song.
You don't own me. I'm not just one of your many toys. You don't own me. Don't say I can't go with other boys. Don't try to change me in any way. You don't know me. Don't tie me down, cause I'll never stay.
Kristen Chenoweth. And like I said, there's more information if you Google her up, you know, kind of her life. I just find it fascinating. I do this all the time, is looking at the different people's lives and seeing how they've achieved what they have, how they, the journey that they've been on. It just makes it more tangible too for everybody else thinking, you know, I could maybe do this. It's not all just magic. It is hard work and opportunities taken advantage of, and being able to have the proverbial shit together when the opportunity does come. I just found this thing I forgot to take with me on the trip that is really an important piece of gear. You can plug that into your phone, and you plug in your power supply, and you can plug your headphones into it, because none of the new phones, you can't plug a headphone in. And there were times where, like, I was traveling and I wanted just to have my headphones on, and I'm going, I can't do it. So I've put this away, so it's right here when I pack for Lyle, so I don't screw up again this time. But again, I've missed everybody so much, and I'm so happy to be back doing this. And got lots, it's going to be a long 10 days here, getting ready to hit the road with Lyle. I look forward to seeing as many folks as I can. It's going to be a fun tour. The band is just so ridiculously great. When he puts the large band together, it is a force of nature. And his new album's great, and he seems to be in a great space. So we're gonna have a great time, a ton of work for 2.5 months, and looking forward to it. We were like in remote places, and one of the things, like, I never could get any news channels that I could understand, you know. So it's heartbreaking to come back and just see just the horrors and misery that are still going on in the Ukraine. I don't know how this is ever going to resolve, even if it ended today, that so much of the country's been decimated. It's tragic. As far as COVID goes, it's still ongoing. You know, when we're working, we have to deal with this, yet you walk out into public. I was at the supermarket yesterday, and I think I saw one person in a mask, and everybody else is walking around, people coughing and stuff, and it's just like... I don't know, and with the mass shootings constantly, I mean, it's a tough world. You know, you really got to work hard to find a space in it that's comfortable and makes you feel good about life. Because you turn on the news, it can get pretty dark. I looked out when I got back, and my backyard is about mostly grown back in from all of the sprinkler work that was done. I locked the backyard so the gardeners weren't here for the 3 weeks. So some of the lawn, that's going to be a challenge when they get here on Friday, and the yard's open, and they're going to go, holy crap. But the good part is it's a ton of grass, and I'm going to put it all in a can, and I use it for my composting. So that'll be good to have. Other than that, I hope everybody's doing well. I've tried to keep up on as much as I can while I've been gone, even though I haven't been able to contribute. I swear to God, boy, you know, going from finally getting my Ethernet cable up to my laptop and things are running at speed, and then suddenly to get into a hotel room where I ran speed test and it barely registered 1 on it. And I'm going, no wonder I can't do a video or anything like that. A man should get birthday wishes and things like that out. But for the most part, man, it was nuts. Just, you know, you get spoiled. You know, you got your routine and all of a sudden... somebody put a 2x4 in the spokes of your bike, you know, and you ground to a halt. So take good care, everybody. I'll be back tomorrow. Really thrilled to, I enjoyed myself, but thrilled to be back with all of you because this is such a cool community here, and I missed you all. So till then, just take good care. I'm going to get this posted, and then I'm off and running, taking care of just lots and lots of stuff that's been waiting for me patiently. And now I'm back, so off to work. So take care. Bye-bye.